Yes. Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about first law in the second unit. First law of thermodynamics for a closed system undergoing a cyclic process. For the evidences, the experimental evidences of Joule's experiment, we will discuss detailedly. Move to the first this unit. Suppose we all know what is first law of thermodynamics up to the introduction of the first steam engine. Law of conservation of energy. Energy neither created nor destroyed. It can be changed one form to another. Now, this is the statement. So based on this statement, we can't design the systems. First thing. Suppose for some examples we'll discuss, then we will get a clear idea about the statement. Suppose some mass is at a elevation, having some potential energy, but because it is head elevation, automatically it contains potential energy, and it is not moving, there is no kinetic energy. Like all reservoirs also we know, but how we are generating the mechanical energy. Next, the stone is moved somewhere, some distance elevation. What happened? The potential energy of the stone is reducing and the kinetic energy of the stone is increasing. Alright? Both are high grade energy only. So you can see here energy balance. Potential energy, initially potential energy 10 kilojoules. Finally, potential energy is reduced to 7 kilojoules and the kinetic energy increases to 3 kilojoules. Energy in equal to energy out. There is no absorption. Second one, because you select any home, continuously we are getting the solar radiation. Means heat, radiative heat, electromagnetic form, without mediator also this heat will transfer. Suppose I am assuming 15 kilojoules of heat is absorbed in the room. We almost through the walls heat loss will take place. We are assuming 3 kilojoules. Then the net change of the energy is this accumulation. Accumulation of the room energy is increasing 12 kilojoules. Then energy in minus energy out equal to change in energy of the system. This room I selected as a system, the change in energy of the system. One more example you can select. Suppose water heater. We are supplying electrical energy, some work, 5 kilojoules. The water temperature is increasing, means the internal energy of the body is increasing. How much it will increase? Only whatever the energy we are supplying, that much only. How I am measuring that rise of the energy, MCP delta T? The temperature rise, the specific heat of the liquid you know, the mass of the liquid you know, the change of energy. If it is adiabatic wall, it is the insulation tank, all water heaters are insulation tanks only. So whatever the work we are supplying, total will convert as a work. In these three examples, heat to heat or work to heat, the common statement instead of law of conservation of energy, energy neither created nor destroyed, it can change one form to another form. With this statement, we can't do any designing procedure. Designing of the systems. So one common statement now we can extract. What is that common statement? Total energy entering minus total energy is leaving equal to change in the total energy of the system. Am I right? Somewhere there is no change, very good, zero. Somewhere there is change, we can do. So first law of thermodynamics, the law of conservation of energy statement, we can rewrite. Total energy entering to the system minus total energy leaving from the system equal to change in total energy of the system. Okay. This is sufficient. This statement we can rewrite. This is sufficient or not? This is a question mark first. First we want to know how many types of the energy transfers are there. Mechanical energy transfer. We know mechanical means the whole effect of the system on surrounding by lifting or lowering it, rotation of the shaft we are achieving. heat transfer, only heat transfer, only work transfer, only heat transfer. Heat transfer, because of temperature difference, the heat will transfer. So two types of the energy transfer. And third energy transfer also is there in open system. With mass, some energy is entering, and with mass, some energy is leaving. So three types of the energy transfers are there: only work transfer, only heat transfer, or heat to work transfer, or with mass energy is entering and with mass energy. Different types of the energy transfers are there. So that common statement of total energy in minus total energy out equal to change in energy also not sufficient. So we want to rewrite the equation, first law of thermodynamic equation for closed system. You know, closed system is mass is not moving, volume is changing, the boundaries are real and mobile boundaries. Second, the first law of thermodynamics for isolated system, neither energy nor mass cross the boundary. In that condition, we want to write the first law of thermodynamics. And third condition, open system. All boundaries are fixed boundaries. The boundaries may be imaginary and real boundaries. Through the imaginary boundary, only mass, with mass some energy is entering, with mass some energy is leaving. So ultimately, now we want to write first law of thermodynamics equation for all types of the systems. First, we will select closed system. And that closed system also, Joule is one of the scientists. Well, because in thermodynamics, generally we are giving statements. After giving statement, well, because the statement up to 1695 or 1711, up to that one, law of conservation of energy is the statement. There is no scientific evidence and all. The first scientist who developed the scientific evidence by his experimental work. The truthful form of scientific evidence developed by the Joules. That's why every time while we are discussing thermodynamics, means first we will discuss about Joules experiment. Cyclic process. In closed system, upon cyclic process, he conducted one experiment. Based on his results, we are writing the first law of thermodynamics for closed system cyclic process. What is this experimental setup? First, we want to know. You see, this is the insulation vessel he selected. This insulation vessel is filled with fluid, any type of fluid, maximum liquid. Initially, he selected water only. The best fluid is water, non-hazardous. We know all properties of water. He filled with water. For measurement of temperature at that year and that BC time, temperature measurement is generally thermocouples. Sorry, thermometer. You must run thermometer for measurement of temperature. Then inserted one stirrer through the pedal wheel. It's connected to the counterweight. We know. By according to thermodynamic work principle, the whole effect of system on surrounding, how we are measuring? By lifting or lowering weight. If work done by the system, if work upon the system by lowering or lifting of the weight, we are applying some work on the system. Here what he did, the counterweight, by lowering or lifting of the weight through the pedal wheel, automatically stirring of the water will take place. So work he is supplying to the system. How much work he is supplied means simple, W into Z, the distance traveled and the counterweight. Simple calculation, W into Z. So this is the applied load, work supplied. By supply of the work, what it will happen? Simple. The temperature of the fluid is increased. I am supplying work, the temperature of the fluid is increased. Means heat generation will take place. So by work input, heat generation is taking place. The first process. Then after what he did, he removed that generated heat. The second process, removal of generated heat. How is removing the generated heat means just by air vent, provision of the air vent is cooling the liquid to the initial condition. But because it's a cyclic operation, initial equal to final. So we achieved that initial equal to final. Okay, this is a one cyclic operation. Like that, number of cycles in conducted experiments, hundreds, thousands of experiments. How thousands of experiments? You will change the different loads, you will change the distance travel, different loads and different distance travels, different work inputs are coming, then different work inputs, different heat generation is coming to the picture. So, different operations, then he tabulated what is the work supplied, how much heat resulted to the ambient in his cyclic operation. Then after, he changed the fluids also. First, initially, he worked with water only. Then after, different fluids also, he substituted. Ultimately, surprisingly, from his table, he found one point. The net work input to the system is directly proportional to net heat transfer. The net work input to the, so from his experiments, the net work input is directly proportional to the net heat transfer. So from the experiments, net summation of all heat interactions for the cyclic operation, not individual process, for the cyclic process, summation of all heat interactions directly proportional to summation of all work interactions. Then we remove the proportionality, we introduce Joule's constant. We know the Joule's constant in SI unit, 1 Newton meter per Joule. In CA units, 426.7 kg of meter per kilocalories. But generally we are dealing in SI units. So net heat transfer equal to net work transfer. There is no accumulation of energy in cyclic operation for closed system. The conditions we want to consider. Closed system or control mass system or non-closed system. In cyclic operation, summation of all heat transfer equal to summation of all work transfer. Then one example, we know heat supplied, always we are considering positive. Heat rejection, always we are considering negative. Work supply, always we consider negative. And work done by the system, always we are considering positive. So, three heat interactions is there, three work interactions is there. According to the any cyclic operation for the closed system, summation of all heat interaction equal to summation of all work interaction. We'll solve some small problem. You can see a closed system exudes a cyclic process during which there are four heat transfers. Here directly they give four heat transactions. Sign also they mentioned. Generally what they are doing, in writing they are giving heat supplied, heat generated, like that. Then you want to assign the sign. Here directly they provided. So heat Q1 224 kilojoules, Q2 20 kilojoules, Q3 minus 200 kilojoules and Q4 37 kilojoules. At 4 points, work is done 3, which are W1 is 50 kilojoules, W2 is 40 kilojoules, W3 is 75 kilojoules. Find the 4th work interaction. So these are the 4 heat interactions is there, 4 work interactions is there. 4th work interaction they are not mentioned, maybe positive, maybe negative. So it is a closed system undergoing cyclic process. That is the statement. Simple logic from the Joule's experiment only. You can calculate summation of all heat interaction equal to summation of all work interaction. Then you can determine the unknown work interaction. Simple problem. So, for the first law of thermodynamics, for closed system undergoing cyclic process. What is the first law of thermodynamics? Summation of all heat interaction equal to summation of all work interaction. There is no accumulation of energy in the system. Okay. With this, I am ending the today's class. Tomorrow we will discuss about next.